hugged me last night, and it was a dream. I was in the house where her and Lou lived, and I saw some things that he had seen. Not through his eyes or through his brain, but through his ears or through his heart, or the blood that ran through his veins, or his pleasure and pain. I saw the husband and imagined that maybe the house had remained just as it was until Lou's last days. We were there for 3 or 4 hours, and it was so unreal that I forgot my name. And Lori gave me a hug, and it felt like a dream. I'm not the kind of guy who would reveal the details of what caught my eye at their house to random girls and guys. With the exception of a birthday gift given to him by Muhammad Ali that was framed, and in that moment I was frozen, and it was just I and me. Uninterrupted, and I thought, oh my God, what two powerful, independent minds. If the two of them converse, it'd probably be the greatest conversation ever in the history of the universe. Nothing but a speck of sand on the beach, but so am I. If you don't like the song or what I have to say, then fuck off and listen to Bye Bye Miss American Pie, 'cause it's from my heart, and so is this next line. I'm a black sheep, baby, and I'll eat you alive. And I'm kind and gentle, and I'm a good listener, and I can read people's eyes. And I'm fun to be around, and I'm endearing, and I can sing songs that make grown men cry. And if you're down and out, I'm not the type to tense up, so spill it, baby, don't be shy. Caroline and Lori shared a love of rat terrier. Walked to the Muhammad Ali framed photo and I stared at it. At least a few times, for it was all too much, as Ali had recently died. And I couldn't help thinking, all of our time will come, you, you, and you, and you too, and I. Tonight I walked around New York all on my own, between Broadway and 5th, and 28th and 34th. I've always loved 32nd Street, Korean Way. The women's bodies around here are curvy and wrapped beautifully. They look like walking decorative vases. And the wonderful taste of bulgogi and kalbi. And the sexy red soup with bean paste and the spicy kimchi. And Madison Square Garden and Joe Louis Plaza. And Jack Dempsey's. And Macy's. I'm sentimental about many things in this 6x2 block radius. Thank you. night Lou is still on my mind. He had a stunning view of the water, as do I. Back in San Francisco, I look at small distant cities and I watch as the boats pass. It was less than 3 years ago that I walked on stage in London just as I heard that Lou had died. I played Caroline Says and the Kids and I talked for a bit and I wanted to cry. Because at the Vancouver Olympics, I had briefly met Lou. And what his album Berlin meant to me, I'm not even gonna try to explain it to you. This year's been a strange motherfucker. People getting killed in America and France, and 2 12-year-old girls are being tried as adults for attempted murder. Where was their father? Where was their mother? While they were being brainwashed by Slenderman, brother, and Trump is all over the TV. Let's face it, we asked for this fuck because we've been surpassed by technology. We've had our heads up our asses, sending selfies around the planet, and getting run over by cars while we jerk off to Pokemon, man. So here's this motherfucker spouting off, and if you think you took no part in his place in this world, then you're fired. Cause you've not been paying attention and your apprenticeship is expired. Then you're fired. Cause you've not been paying attention and your apprenticeship is expired. Then you're fired. Cause you've not been paying attention and your apprenticeship is expired. Then you're fired. Cause you've not been paying attention and your apprenticeship is expired. Then you're fired. Cause you've not been paying attention and your apprenticeship is expired. I digress, but I keep following my path that led me from first year in Berlin when I was 19 to the power of the heart, where Lou's tribute concert I sung and I was honored to have taken part. And the night was magical and humid and dark. Lori looked for sun, Lou looked for rain. Well, she had the sun that day, and at night Lou had his rain. And I did what I came here to do and shared the Lincoln Center stage with all that talent and those amazing singers and all those original brains. And tonight for 30 seconds I hear sirens creeping up and trailing off. And as I walked, I saw sparrows and thought of my very first trip to New York. 1992, all I could afford was pizza and Dunkin' Donuts. And I had 20 bucks left over that I spent on a stripper behind a window who reached down and jerked me off. I had a cassette Walkman back then. I knew a girl who lived in the Bronx. Went out one night and saw a movie, Glengarry, Glenn Ross. I remember that just now in this humidity as I turn and toss. Thinking about Lou and the beautiful things he had, not what he had lost. Friends and poetry, the love of his life and his beautiful house. Gonna go to sleep now, as in this moment, there's nothing more to write. Thank you, Lori. I'm forever grateful for that night.